greatest day in history, and during this song as it plays, just encourage you to follow the actions that Mel's going to lead us in for that as we begin our service to celebrate during this Holy Communion service that the Lord Jesus is indeed alive. This is the greatest day in history that we celebrate today.
Thank you. You might think that Easter is all about eggs. Hunting for hidden and hard-boiled eggs. But Easter is less about looking for eggs than looking for something else. It starts with some women bound for a tomb. Jesus was dead and armed with perfume. They went down before dawn in the deep morning gloom to anoint their friend's body with spices. But when they arrive, the body was gone. The tomb had been opened. Somehow, by someone. But opened by whom? And why was it done? And where was his body now? You might think that Easter is all about bunnies. Bunnies are quick. I really like bunnies. But Easter is less about quick little bunnies. Something much quicker by far. For quicker than bunnies, two angels appeared. dazzled the women, then said, "Do not fear, Jesus is back.
Yay!
He's alive, he's not here. Now go and tell his friends what you see." So quicker than bunnies. The women ran off. They told Jesus' friends. But some of them laughed. So Peter ran back to see for himself and believe what the women said. You might think that Easter is all about spring. Things springing to life once again in the spring. But Easter is less about new life in spring than springing to life forever. For when Jesus rose, he had a new body. A living forever. Whatever, new body. A not dying ever and clever new body. That surprised every one of his friends. He walked in the room, though the door had been locked. It's a ghost. Ooh. His friends whispered, frightened and shocked.
Oh, scared.
Touch my hands, said Jesus. Feel the nail marks. It's me. I'm really here. You might think that Easter is all about chocolate. Chocolate's amazing. I love to eat chocolate. But Easter is so much sweeter than chocolate. Much sweeter than chocolate. By far. For when he appeared to 500 more friends, his time here on earth came at last to an end. And up through the clouds in the sky Jesus went to sit at the right hand of God. Now go tell my story, he said to his friends. Tell them alive and that shortly I'll send my own Holy Spirit to fill them when they believe and receive my love. A new life for now, changed and forgiven. A new life forever that just keeps on living. Even after you die, it's the gift I'll be giving. Sweeter than chocolate. Fresher than spring. Quicker than bunnies. Better than eggs. Best Easter present of all.
come there to share any time of remembering the peace that Jesus brought us. As that greatest day in history brought us freedom, brought us new life, and also brought us such amazing peace to live within our hearts forever, and peace between one another. So if you've not joined us for a while, today, then just to let you know, the signing of a peace is like this. So it's peace with you. So the risen Lord Jesus Christ came and stood among his disciples and said, "Peace be with you." Then they were glad when they saw the Lord. Alleluia. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So step back in each direction. Lord, have mercy. Like the disciples behind locked doors, we are afraid to be seen as your followers. Christ, have mercy. Like Thomas in the upper room, we are slow to believe. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
And we pray together this prayer on the screen. Almighty God, who in Jesus Christ has given us a kingdom that cannot be destroyed, forgive us our sins, open our eyes to God's truth, strengthen us to do God's will, and give us the joy of his kingdom, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Dave's going to bring us our first reading.
First reading is from Psalm 118. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Let Israel say, his love endures forever. Let the house of Aaron say, his love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, his love endures forever. When hard pressed, I cried to the Lord. He brought me into a spacious place. The Lord is with me, I will not be afraid. What can mere mortals do to me? The Lord is with me, he is my helper. I look in triumph on my enemies. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in humans. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. All the nations surrounded me, but in the name of the Lord I cut them down. They surrounded me on every side, but in the name of the Lord I cut them down. They swarmed around me like bees, but they were consumed as quickly as burning thorns. In the name of the Lord I cut them down. I was pushed back and about to fall, but the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and my defence. He has become my salvation. Shouts of joy and victory resound in the tents of the righteous. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. The Lord's right hand is lifted high. The Lord's right hand has done mighty things. I will not die but live, and will proclaim what the Lord has done. The Lord has chastened me severely, but he has not given me over to death. Open for me the gates of the righteous, and I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks, for you have answered me, you have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected have become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvellous in our eyes. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad. Lord, save us. Lord, grant us success. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. From the house of the Lord we bless you. The Lord is God, and he has made his light shine on us. With bows in hand, join in the festal procession up to the horns of the altar. You are my God, and I will praise you. You are my God, and I will exalt you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. His love endures forever. Amen.
Please stand if you're comfortably able for the reading of the Gospel.
This is the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, according to John 20:1-18.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Early on the first day of the week, while it was still dark, Mary Magdalene went to the tomb and saw that the stone had been removed from the entrance. So she came running to Simon Peter and the other disciples, the one Jesus loved, and said, "They have taken the Lord out of the tomb, and we don't know where they have put him." So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple ran out Peter and reached him first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in. Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen. Finally, the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, went inside. He saw and believed, but did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. Then the disciples went back to where they were staying.
Then Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They've taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realise it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you're looking for?" Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned to him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
If you're comfortably able, please continue standing as we have another action song, "Our God Is a Great God."
Thank you.
take a seat. So, Lord, Heavenly Father, you are bigger than we could ever fully know, and we pray that in these minutes now you teach us just a little bit more about the joy of Easter this morning, Lord, that you've made us open in these minutes. In Jesus' wonderful name, amen. So I want you to imagine for a moment that you're living in Jerusalem around the time of Jesus, when he was physically walking the earth. You're a reporter for the Jerusalem Chronicle, a newspaper that goes out to everybody living in Jerusalem. And every day you write up news stories that are either good or bad news, but mostly bad, because that's what always seems to sell the newspaper. I'm going to tell you some facts from the life of Jesus, and I want you to work out if the story or that fact is good news or bad news, and to shout that out. Is that okay with everyone? Okay, wonderful. So, right then, so first, Jesus was born in Bethlehem, in a place where animals were kept. Is that good news or is it bad news?
Good news.
Right, good news. Anyone indifferent to it? Just think it's just something that we know about?
Yes.
Well, we might have a little bit of mixed view on that. It could just be a fact, but the Bible does tell us that it was good news. So well done to everyone who said that was good news. We think about that, of course, when we're at the time of year of Christmas. And we know that this is good news because of some particular verses in the Bible from Luke chapter 2 that say, I bring you news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today in the town of David, a Saviour has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. Okay, so the second fact. And I mentioned about Jesus that I'd like you to tell me your opinion about is this. So Jesus was once with 5,000 really hungry people, okay, and there were only 5 small loaves of bread and 2 fish that were there with them. And Jesus managed to feed them all nonetheless. So is this good news or bad news? What do you think? Just call out.
Right here.
Good news. It sounds pretty wonderful. It sounds awesome. It sounds like it means that Jesus was someone who could do mighty miracles. So yes, it's not surprising that we learn in the Bible in Matthew 14 that this was really good news. It says in that chapter that they all ate and they were satisfied. And the disciples even managed afterwards to gather 12 basketfuls with the broken pieces that were left over. Okay, so the third fact that I'll mention is this one. So Jesus healed a man that was born blind, but he did it on the Jewish holy day, on the Jewish Sabbath. And that really angered so many religious people. Didn't want to see that happening at all on the Sabbath. So is that good news or is that bad news?
Good news.
Good news, yeah? Yeah, so you're exactly right. It is brilliant, wonderful, good news. Because even though it upset those Jewish leaders, those religious people at the time, it showed that Jesus is from God and that he is God. That he's full of love and power that can only come from him being God. And so the Bible tells us in Luke 4 that Jesus said that he would be the one who would bring sight to the blind, that he would bring so much light and ability to see to the whole world. And the last fact that I'm going to mention this morning that I want you to comment on might be a little bit more difficult to share your opinion about, or it might be that you feel a little concerned about sharing your opinion. So please don't worry at all, just call out once again. So Jesus hung and died on a cross on that first Good Friday. Is that good news or is that bad news?
Good news.
Okay, so somebody like to just call out to tell us why you would say this is good news?
Because he was the only one good enough to give his life.
It's saying he was the only one good enough to give his life. Thank you. Does anybody else like to share, in your own words, why Good Friday was good news and is good news today still?
It's the hope of salvation.
Yeah, Graham, it's the hope of our salvation. Praise God. Lily, do you want to share something? It seemed on the surface level as though it was sad and bad news. And for so many at the time looking on, they felt like it was awful, that this was just terrible, but this Holy One was being treated in such an awful, terrible way. But as Peter follows, he was the only one good enough. Jesus, the Son of God, he came to be that Saviour. He was the only one who could stand in our place, because he's the only one who was perfect and holy enough. But 3 days later, the news changed and it got even better. We heard in our John 20 reading that Sue and Abby brought for us this morning that Jesus came back to life. Then in verse 18 it said, "I have seen the Lord." Mary was able to declare that. Jesus had been raised from the dead and was walking around Galilee for all people to see him. How good is that news? Would you just wave your flag if you agree that this is good news? Not everyone's got a flag, so we're not one between two, but just wave that as a declaration that this is good news. Great. Yeah, so and we can continue waving the flags if you want to, as I just declare a few more things that this means. So it's really good news because it means that Jesus is who he claimed to be, as I've just said. It also means that his death on the cross dealt with our wrong thoughts, our wrong words, all the things that we would do on a daily basis as well, that mean we need to be forgiven. He made it possible for us to be free. And it means that we can be part of God's family and enjoy a relationship with him forever. It's so great to be here today. And that is a visual reminder that we are the family of God. And it also means Easter Sunday and Jesus' resurrection. It means that we can know such love, such peace, joy, freedom and hope living within us today and always. No matter what we might ever go through, at school, at college, at home, in our work or our personal lives, Jesus' presence is alive. He is alive. He's risen. And this is very good news. So I'd like to invite you to say these words when I've counted to three. So Jesus is alive and he is alive in me. One, two,
Jesus is alive, and he is alive in me.
Amen to that. Right, so we continue now by declaring our faith in the Lord. So if you're comfortable and able, please stand as we do this together. We say together, I believe in God, Father, Holy Spirit, creator and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come
come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please take a seat and Mother Mary and lead us in our prayers.
There is a response. When I say Lord of Life, please respond through saying, hear our prayers. Lord of Life, loving God, we praise you for this day of celebration, this day of praise, this day of thanksgiving, a day that changes the way we think, the way we act, the way we live, that changes everything. Lord of Life, and so we pray now for changing our world, for changing all those places where there is human need. We pray for the poor, the homeless, the sick and the hungry. Lord of Life,
hear our prayers.
We pray for the victims of war, for refugees, for divided communities and countries. Lord of Life,
hear our prayers.
We pray for the sorrowful, the fearful, the troubled in heart and mind. Lord of Life, we pray for the prosecuted, the imprisoned, and the exploited. Lord of Life, hear our prayers. Living God, may the truth of Easter break into each and every one of these situations, bringing help and healing, strength and support, comfort and courage, hope and health, faith and freedom, love and life. The change that you alone can bring, Lord of Life,
hear our
prayers. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
We continue by saying the Lord's Prayer together. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom and the power are the glory of yours.
And reflect once more on Jesus, that he is alive as Pete prays for us.
Life flow from
So, Lord, we ask that you would be right at the centre as we celebrate this blessed and holy meal. Amen. Just to say, during communion, this will be leading us in spiritual communion. As I distribute the wafers, so if you feel more at ease to just stay in your seat rather than to come forward, then please just know that that is completely fine. And also, if you prefer to receive a prayer of blessing, then you can do that this morning. It's just to come forward and naturally keep that social distance, and I'll pray that prayer of blessing for you. And then this morning, as it's the first Sunday of the month, we're having our children focused Eucharistic prayer. And so for our holies and our men's, we're going to respond in the following way. So the first holy, and later on the Amen, will be said by our children and young people. Our second holy, our ladies, we'll say, and then the final one, our gentlemen. And so the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is always right to give you thanks, God our Creator, loving and faithful, holy and strong. You made us and the whole universe and filled your world with life.
Holy.
You sent your Son to live among us, Jesus, our Saviour, Mary's child. He suffered on the cross, he died to save us from our sins, he rose in glory from the dead.
Holy.
You send your Spirit to bring new life to the world, and you clothe us with power from on high. And so we join the angels to celebrate and sing.
Holy,
Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of glory, and Hosanna in Christ. Father, on the night before he died, Jesus shared a meal with his friends. He took the bread and function. He broke it and gave it to them, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this to remember me." And after the meal, Jesus took the cup of wine. He functioned and gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood, the new promise of God's unfailing love. Do this to remember me." Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Father, as we bring this bread and wine and remember his death and resurrection, send your Holy Spirit that we who share his gifts may be fed by Christ's body and his blood. Amen. Pour your Spirit on us that we might love one another, work for the healing of the earth, and share the good news of Jesus as we await his coming in glory.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
For honour and praise belong to you, Father, with Jesus, your Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Though we are many, we are one body.
Because we all share in one bread.
Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ as he gave for you, and feed on him in your hearts by faith and with thanksgiving.
Spiritual communion. And so as we begin, we reflect is very special. We reflect on our thankfulness for Jesus and what he brought us, and our thankfulness that he rose from the dead. We think about our relationships, for our family and friends, wherever they are in the gathering, perhaps we'll see them today. If you won't, we think about those people we know. What good things have come from God today? Where have I fallen short? What things might I have written to Jesus, the risen Jesus, knowing all he did for us for the forgiveness of our sins? And what might I do tomorrow? Believe that nothing can separate me from your love. days of challenge, make us stronger in you. In these days of emptiness, take possession of us. In these days of waiting, open our hearts to the mystery of your cross. Amen. And may the Lord bless us, and preserve us from all evil, and keep us in eternal life. Amen. Thank you.
Jesus has done for us. Let's pray together and pray on the screen.
Lord God, you feed us with the living bread from heaven. Renew our faith, increase our hope,
and strengthen our love.
Teach us to hunger for Christ,
who is the true and living bread, and to live by every word that comes from your mouth. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Short pieces of church family news. So if you'd like to actually all sing together, you can do that this afternoon at 5 o'clock outside, as since last weekend we've been permitted to sing as a congregation, but as long as it's outside. And so we have an area of prayer service happening then, and it'd be really great to see you if you'd like to come and join us for that. If you feel like you might need a chair, then just bring deck chairs with you, if you feel like you might be able to stand for that long. We'll be able to accommodate up to 60, so if you come and it looks like there's a lot more people, then you know, feel free to go back home and watch the recording of the service that's going to be premiered at 6:30. That is a service that all focused upon the Emmaus Road experience, when Jesus met those two early followers on the road to Emmaus. I'm going to finish with joining in for Mind with the Glory, so I just encourage you to wave your flags, and we'll bring some flags here for you not as well. So, yeah.
Thank you.
strength for you to walk with him in his risen life, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you today and always. Amen. We are raised to new life with Christ. Go in his peace. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.